and welcome. In this video, we will discover 12 things rich people do that poor people don't. There must be some reason why certain men are able to stay rich and grow their fortunes while the rest struggle to make ends meet. Wealth is a state of consciousness. It is a mind conditioned to succeed. Understand this, and any actions towards financial independence will follow effortlessly. The self-made rich aren't necessarily smarter than anyone else, but they have mastered some important principles that help them get ahead and stay ahead. Most important, they treat building wealth as a learnable skill, and it's one that you can learn too. The reason why rich people get to live the most amazing lifestyles possible while the poor people are just struggling to get by are because the rich do things differently. So if you'd like to join the ranks of the super wealthy, try honing these 12 habits and lifestyle changes and see what financial freedom truly feels like. But just before, make sure you subscribe to the channel and don't forget to download your free book on financial freedom by clicking on the link in the description below. 1. They are confident in their abilities. Rich people usually radiate confidence. This might seem like a chicken or the egg sort of scenario. Are they confident because they are rich, or did they become rich because they are confident? The truth is somewhere in between. Everyone is human and we all experience self-doubt sometimes. A successful person is aware of their strengths as well as their weaknesses. They understand that they cannot be an expert at everything, but they feel great about the areas where their skills shine the most. Successful people know that they just need to get started and keep moving forward. Everyone is going to have a different ability they do the best. Maybe you're great with kids, or maybe you're skilled with working with your hands. Maybe you have a beautiful voice or incredible physical strength. Each and every person is special in their own way. So instead of feeling down on yourself for the things you are not, try to highlight the things that make you amazing. Once you identify your strengths, it becomes easier to build and monetize those skills. 2. They are friends with other successful people. There's a very famous quote that we have used multiple times here at Self-Made. It is that you are the summation of the 5 closest people in your life. The reason why we use this so much is that it is absolutely true. Sometimes our friends and even our family can hold us back from being the best we can be. For example, if you grew up in a rough neighborhood and you continue to hang out with people who break the law, it's going to be difficult for you to rise above your circumstances. Yes, there is such a thing as loyalty, and it is possible to maintain early friendships throughout your lifetime. However, if your friends are putting you in a bad situation, they are not someone you should have in your life. Your friends should lift you up during hard times and be there to celebrate your victories. Sometimes, insecure family and friends might try to bring you down with negative talk. They might doubt your abilities to succeed and try to tell you to give up before you can even try. This says so much more about them than it does about you. Happy, successful people build each other up instead of bringing others down. They understand that there is room for everyone to succeed, and they want the best for everyone in their life. This is the kind of person that you need on a difficult journey of self-improvement. 3. They educate themselves. People who aspire to be successful are constantly trying to learn as much as humanly possible about the industry they want to specialize in. Even if they have a master's degree in the subject, there is likely to be more to learn that would help them be better at their job or business. Learning is a lifelong journey. No matter how smart and educated you might be, there is always something new to learn. This new information might be the difference between remaining poor and becoming rich. On the flip side, there are people who do not enjoy learning new things. Maybe they struggled in school and were tired of that constant uphill battle learning things they would never use in real life. They would rather continue their day-to-day lives doing exactly what they feel comfortable with. These people know how to do their job well, so they stick to it. There is absolutely nothing wrong with living this way, but it won't make you rich. 4. They buy instead of rent. When you rent an apartment or a house from a landlord, you are paying for someone else's mortgage. In fact, you are paying more than whatever your landlord pays in mortgage and taxes, because they need to make a profit. Yes, they are taking on the financial risk as a homeowner if repairs need to be made. But in the majority of cases, landlords are making money and gaining assets while tenants are simply giving their money away to temporarily occupy a space. Financially, this does not make a lot of sense to rent, You can never get that money back, and it is not building as an investment. Of course, buying a property is easier said than done. You need a good credit score, a down payment, and more upfront to get started. But if you can manage to buy a property, you'll get at least one step closer to becoming rich. 5. They buy products that last. When rich people go shopping, they think about how long the product will last. They don't have all the time in the world to keep going out for new items when something breaks, so they would prefer to get the highest quality up front. Shopping with this mindset actually helps you save money in the long run because you are less likely to need to replace the same things over and over. For example, if you buy clothing from places like Forever 21, you might find that the clothing shrinks or falls apart in 2 weeks. Compare that to some of the other more expensive brands out there where you could have a shirt for 10 years if it's made well enough. The same could be said for buying products in bulk. Rich people usually made a lot of money because they were good with numbers. They understand that in most cases, buying in bulk will save them money in the long run. It's also far more convenient to have a huge stockpile of everyday items instead of making a weekly trip to the grocery store. Even if certain bulk products cost more money, if it means saving a few hours of their time, it is absolutely worth it. Number 6. Capsule wardrobes. All self-made millionaires earn their money by working very hard. Many of them don't have the time to figure out what to wear in the morning, let alone worry about the latest fashion. This is why many of them will hire a professional stylist to help them when they go to a special event. They are also more likely to subscribe to the idea of owning a capsule wardrobe. Think about people like Steve Jobs. He was known for always wearing the same black turtleneck to work at Apple. When you think about a lot of the other big CEOs out there, the majority of them don't care about walking around in flashy designer brands unless they made their money from the fashion or beauty industry. Rich people are far more likely to go for solid colors made of high-quality fabrics. These pieces can be versatile when mixed and matched. The easier it is to figure out what to wear in the morning, the better. Just focus on what looks good on you. 7. They increase income instead of saving. There's a popular phrase, nobody saves their way to becoming a billionaire. The rich are far more focused on increasing their income rather than pinching pennies. It's difficult for your brain to focus on both objectives at the same time. If you choose to try saving money, you will find that life gives you the opportunities to do so. And if you focus your energy on making more money, you will begin to discover more ways to do it. It's just a matter of choosing one focus over the other. This is similar to the phenomenon that once you buy a certain type of car, you suddenly see it all the time on the road. Those cars were always there, you just never noticed them until you were able to recognize and identify it. There is even a psychological name for this called the Bader-Meinhof phenomenon. It happens to every single person, so no matter who you are, this can work. Opening up your mind to money-saving opportunities can be great in a lot of ways, but if you want to be rich, choose money-making instead. Number 8. They don't stretch themselves too thin. There is a phrase that some people are serial entrepreneurs, and some people make the mistake in believing that if they want to be rich, they need to open multiple businesses. It's true that some people love to start one new company after another. But most of the time, people who succeed are the ones who focus on one or two specialties. They become the master of something and make sure it is running smoothly before they branch off into something different. Even in these new ventures, it's usually somehow related to the previous idea or company. For example, Amazon started out selling books online. Then they realized that people wanted to buy more products besides books. So they continued with their same online retail platform and simply added new products. 9. The big picture. Most people go through their day-to-day lives only thinking about themselves. They think about bills, food, sex, friendships, family, and everything else in their own little bubble. Occasionally, they might watch the news and discuss politics, but it's not the main thing they're concerned about. Those who make a lot of money usually found a way to solve a problem that was bigger than themselves. They are thinking about the world at large, rather than their own life. For example, Jeff Bezos came up with Amazon.com as an online bookstore. He knew that people out there would be looking for books they could not find in their local stores. As time went on, he realized that people could benefit from buying all kinds of products online. At the end of the day, he was simply solving an issue and looking forward into the future. He understood human nature and knew that people would love a service like this. Even now, Amazon continues to spread their reach wider and wider with the services they offer, all with the goal of making people's lives more convenient. Number 10. They get rich with other people's money. Millennials are known for struggling with debt. We have massive amounts of student loans left to pay as well as credit cards. Most of us aspire to be debt-free, and it can seem like a total nightmare to imagine borrowing money at all. Some people assume that the rich are totally debt-free, but they are not. Many of them are borrowing money because they know the secrets to profit from it. Believe it or not, there is a such thing as good debt, and rich people get into it all the time. These are loans that are used to make good investments. For example, let's pretend you borrow $150,000 from the bank to buy a house, and the mortgage repayment is $1,000 per month. Once you get the house, you put it up for rent for $1,500 per month. This tenant is paying for your mortgage, and you also get to pocket $500 per month. If you've never thought about these concepts before, check out the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad. 11. They have both short-term and long-term investments. Lower and middle-class people don't have any savings at all, and if they do, it's in a savings account with their bank that earns less than 1% interest. The rich know that they need to save both short-term and long-term investments. Once they have an investment that is meant for their retirement or their children, they don't touch that money with a 10-foot pole. There is no option to withdraw early in case of emergency. Short-term investments are something they expect to make money on in the next 10 years or less. This could be flipping real estate, day trading stocks, etc. Then there are legacy investments that could be passed down to your children. For example, if you buy a painting from one of the great artists of the century, it may be worth double the money 50 years from now. If you're just starting out with building your wealth, you probably want to focus on short-term investments. Once you are debt-free and have some money to spare, you can set money aside for future generations. 12. They wake up hours before starting work. You have probably heard people say that rich people wake up at 4 a.m. while others vehemently deny it. Their wake-up time will vary depending on when they start working. What is actually true is the mood successful people begin their day with and how they can calmly and efficiently prepare for the day. Amazon's Jeff Bezos reportedly sits down with his family for breakfast every day because it's a priority for him. Many other successful people might go for a run, listen to music, shower, and have activities that help wake them and get focused. No matter who you are, it's important to give yourself time in the morning. Think about how you feel when you wake up late and rush to work. You probably don't look your best because you didn't have time to put on makeup or style your hair. It's likely that you feel frazzled and may have forgotten to eat breakfast. It can ruin someone's entire day. In general, be sure to set your alarms and go to bed at a decent hour every day. There is no specific timetable leading to wealth, but statistics state that following some simple rules can turn into positive habits, which can turn into positive results, which can lead you on a path to financial wealth. Just know that if you follow the advice shared by the wealthy, that these successful tips can get you one step closer to the lifestyle you desire and deserve. Don't waste your mental energy on ruminations or negative thought loops that will make you second-guess yourself. The wealthy don't. Financially responsible and successful people don't build their wealth by accident or overnight. Becoming rich takes serious willpower and long-term vision. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, comment, and especially subscribe to the channel. You're also free to receive the new book, 5 Steps to Reach Financial Freedom, by clicking on the link in the description below the video.